Now let me start today's class not by talking about pronoun first, but by repeating what I said yesterday at the end of the class. Many of you have the same questions. Thousands of people ask, is it necessary to learn grammar to learn English? Many hundreds ask, how to improve vocabulary? Some people ask, how can we make our pronunciation better? Somebody says, we want to improve our spellings, or we want to improve our punctuation. How to improve spoken English? How to improve written English? These are all questions which are asked by everybody. Everybody wants to do that. I want to give only one answer to this. Don't make these as separate compartments. For learning, we are dividing it into separate compartments. But language is one single unit. We have to learn all of them together. By learning vocabulary separately, grammar separately, pronunciation separately, we cannot learn a language. We have to learn them all together. What we are doing now is, I have given you yesterday some sentences. Did you go and practice at home? Not many are saying yes. See, the only way of learning is practicing. If I give you 10 sentences, you will find that those 10 are not enough. You need to make them 10,000. When you do 10,000, you will improve. By 10 sentences which I give, you will never improve. So the improvement depends on you, how much you are going to practice. Somebody here asked about vocabulary. You know, in one list I gave you names of professions. Then in the sheet which I showed you, I said I want to become an IAS officer. So each of you could have chosen, I want to become an architect, I want to become an engineer, I want to become a doctor, a scientist, a surgeon, or you want to become any of the other things which are listed, which you know. But nobody used that. 90% of you read the same thing which I have put, which means vocabulary does not improve. We know the word, but we don't use the word. Many times I gave you pronunciations. You might have noticed that many pronunciations are there in each of these words. Each sentence also there is pronunciation. By learning words pronunciation, we can never speak a language. We have to learn full sentence. Therefore, when we are reading those sentences, you are learning grammar, pronunciation, vocabulary, everything together. Please remember, like that when you read the newspaper, one sentence of the newspaper is teaching you all skills of English. You don't have to read from a textbook. You have to learn from real life. That is how language is learned. Any language. Today you want to learn English. All of you need English. But any language, India has so many languages. You want to learn any language, you remember that learn the language as a whole. Learn the language naturally. Not by learning only one part of the language, separately grammar. You know, if they give you a grammar test, you get 10 marks, full mark. You make mistakes in grammar. While writing the exam, you got full marks. While speaking, you didn't get full marks. Reason? You don't practice. So in the class, all of you practiced yesterday, maybe 100, 200 sentences. At home, if you go and practice at least 1,000 sentences, of your own, not my sentences, of your own making, even if you make mistakes, no problem. I have given you structures of sentences. In those structures, you put different words. First list I gave you, only simple nouns. You must be knowing at least another 1000 simple nouns. If you make sentence one sentence, this is, you know, I didn't say this is a camera. We see camera there. So you can make this is a camera. I did not say so many other things. So like that, you choose, you write, you practice by speaking, not practice by writing only, by speaking. The more you speak, the better your machine becomes. You know, God has given this voice machine. So now that machine is capable of doing Telugu. Have you seen musical instruments? You know, when they come to the stage, they tune the instrument. So from Telugu to English, we have to tune. When you're speaking Telugu, different tune. When you're speaking English, again you have to tune. How to do it? By practice. You see small child learning a bicycle. Have you seen? You know, that bicycle is not like ours. It has one small stand like that, so that there is balance. The child will have balance like this, and the child learns to cycle. So grammar, vocabulary, all this is balance. But the real thing is, when you want to go on a bicycle or on a motorcycle, do you have any stands? You don't. You just have two wheels. That is how language is. These are all support. We don't want support. We want the real English. That real English comes only when you practice. That is why whatever you are learning in 5 days, you need to practice again and again. Yesterday only we did nouns, but unless you practice, nouns are most important. Unless you practice, you cannot benefit. Okay? Today we are doing pronoun, as you can see on the board, that today's lesson is pronoun. Now pronoun, the one great function of pronoun is, instead of mentioning a name, instead of mentioning a noun, we use a pronoun. For all the nouns commonly which we use, we say it. I say this is a table, then I say it is a table. So it I have not used anywhere in the exercises, because we all know it. Where we make mistake is in he and she and I and you. So all our exercises are like that. These are called personal pronouns. That means they are used for persons, for people. We use these pronouns. See, in our language also we have pronouns. If you translate and see, you will have in Telugu many more pronouns than English. Because we have different pronouns for respect form, you. We have different pronoun for same age, you. We have different pronoun for youngsters, you. When we want to say you, three different levels of pronouns. So more pronouns in our languages. It should not be difficult. Remember, when you're learning a new language, the first level is your mother tongue. You should take help from your mother tongue. Basic English, when you want to learn, only ground level, your mother tongue is very helpful. When you want to learn advanced English, leave your mother tongue far away, because then your mother tongue becomes a hindrance. It becomes a barrier to learning. So basic level, beginner's level, mother tongue is very helpful. Specialized level, higher level, mother tongue is not useful. So if you are learning English at the basic level, at the beginner's level, please take help from your mother tongue. That is very, very useful. Whenever you have difficulty with a word, you think of that word in Telugu, in your own mother tongue. And then you can translate it into English by looking. These days we have translation on internet only. You don't even need a dictionary. If you give that Telugu word, immediately they will give you the English word. Any language it can do like that. Whole software is available for translating books and papers, everything. You see a message in Facebook which is written in your mother tongue, it says see translation. You touch it, you get English version of that. Have you seen? So that is how language is learnt. If you have problem, you write it in Telugu, you touch that and you see your own Telugu is translated into English. Can't you learn on your own? You don't need a teacher. You have to teach yourself. You know, our culture says that your mind is your best teacher. You are your best teacher. Your mind is your best teacher. So don't depend on outside teachers at all. Use yourself. But then, we are not like that. We depend. 3 to 5, madam will take class. 27 to 31st. Finished. English learning over. Now, this is the first step. This is part 1. Part 2 is your homework every day. And part 3 is your lifelong. From 2019 for the next 100 years. All of you are very young. You will live for many years. So till the last day of your life you learn. I might have taught English for 40 years. I cannot say I finished learning. I'm still learning. Every day we learn something new. So we go on learning. This is the tradition of India. You know, India gave a lot of importance to intellect. Today we give importance only to money. If you have a lot of money, I'll say salam. Earlier they used to say that the guru is the best. You know, guru is like God. Today we have no respect for intellect. So Indians are becoming without intellect because they are not using their intellect. Lot of brain God has given, but we are keeping in the bank. We are not using it. So please practice on your own. Please use. If I give one sentence, you must be able to give 1,000 sentences. Yesterday Bharat asked a question. How to say the same thing again and again? In different versions, same word in different versions. Unless you practice saying it, how will you say? If you want to explain anything in your mother tongue, imagine how many words you can use for one explanation. You can use 10 different varieties of words that we don't have in English because we are not practicing English. So I would like to tell you again and again that unless you practice, it is not good enough. Yesterday I made you read because I wanted to correct your pronunciation. But in 1 hour, 2 hours, nothing changes. You have to go on practicing it forever, remembering how it was practiced in the class, how it was pronounced in the class. Okay? Today we will see many types of pronouns. One of them which maximum mistakes are made, myself. You know, always we have problem. I was just reading a book before coming. I have to review that book. And I saw a sentence. My friend and myself took part in the freedom struggle. That is not correct. It's a good book, but English is not good. It's my friend and I, not my friend and myself. Myself can never come unless the word I comes in the same sentence. Where you use the word I, you can use myself. Alone, myself, you cannot use. Yesterday I told you while telling the name, many videos I think I have mentioned this. Don't say myself Sai Kumar. Don't say myself Devi. That is not the way to introduce yourself. Myself has a special use. So we will read those things also. I am not giving all the points of grammar because already those grammar things are there on impact videos. You please see those grammar videos. This is only practical session. I wanted small group because practical session. My idea is that if I give 10 sentences practice, the students who have come here will do 1,000 sentences from those 10. Not now. You do it later. Do it after 1 year. Do it after 2 years. But that is it. What I am giving you is only seed. You know, you take a mango and you put it. After 5 years, you will see mango tree. You won't see immediately, no? Yesterday you put the seed and today you say, I want to eat one mango. Not possible. You have to wait. So what I am giving you is only the seed. Now you have to go home and you have to water it nicely, put it in a very fertile soil and then look after the plant very well so that the goat doesn't come and eat the plant. Then it will grow into a big tree. Do you understand? These examples I am giving you to make you understand that you are your own English teacher. You don't need English teacher. You are your own teacher. Do you agree? Will you practice? Okay. So I hope after the course is over, you'll practice.